Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for seeing the online version of the Crossing Community Church Sunday School process in class. And today we're going to extend what Sister Maddie did last week, talking through justification, righteousness, and then we're going to talk about, as Paul put it in the book of Romans, what faith do we need? And he refers to Abraham as the righteous one. And so we're going to be talking about that as well. Now, as Maddie indicated last week, Paul spent pretty much the first part of his letter to the Romans explaining the dire spiritual situation that all of us were in, and both Gentiles and Jews. Now, the Gentiles ignored the truth of God because they went and they started to worship other idols and other artifacts, if you will, that showed what their faith lacked. Now, the Jews considered themselves superior to the Gentiles, but they were separated from God with their sin just like the Gentiles were. And so both of them kind of reached a point where the end of the rope occurred and God sent a way for that rope to be pulled up. So in chapter 3, Paul turned an important corner in that relationship, and he talked about all have sinned and are separated from God. That's the basic key, and it was man's own doing. And so when we realize the opportunity that we have to visualize the fact that even if in our best possible moments we have still original sin, there's nothing we can do because we are separated from God unless we receive Christ by faith and by grace. So the way of acknowledging God's grace and coming to him through faith in Christ is the only way that we can resolve that separation issue from original sin to being renewed in Christ. Instead of relying on our own efforts, we need to look forward and toward the finished work of Jesus on the cross. That'll make all the difference in our lives. Mm-hmm. So humans have no reason to brag, even if they come to Christ through faith. There's really no reason to brag about that process because we didn't do the work. God through Christ did that work. And all we have and all we belong results in Christ. It doesn't make any difference who you are, whether you're a Jew or a Gentile. God's offer of faith and salvation, as was explained last week, extends to all. The old saying that the cross is the ground is level at the foot of the cross applies to all of us, and we need to be realistic about who we worship and what he has accomplished through the saving grace that Jesus brought to us. If the Jews would look back at their history, what would be evident is that Jesus is our only hope, that God is the only way. And their patriarch Abraham was redeemed by faith long before Moses received the law on Mount Sinai. And that's going to be in chapter 4, verses 1 through 3. David also recognized the importance of faith. And Paul emphasized the quote from Psalms, and we're not going to have time to go into that today, but I want to let you know that all that we have, all of our justification, all of our righteousness, all of our present relationship is through the power of grace and the power of faith. And what we have is Jesus providing that opportunity as an atonement and a sacrifice for us. And the verses that we're going to talk about today are going to share that relationship. You see the cartoon about Abraham showing off on the screen. Well, let me point out that Abraham is looking at pictures of his grandchildren. And according to Paul, your photo could be there. So you want to make sure that you take a hard look at all of that. So what is righteousness and what is justification? Well, since that word group in Greek, also in Hebrew, as it turns out, can be translated justification, the assignment was let's grasp the range of meaning of what those terms encompass. And so we're going to take a look at some of the scripture that's inherent to this. Last week we looked at verses 21 through 26. But now our righteousness from God apart from law has been made known, to which the law and the prophets testify. This righteousness from God comes through faith in Jesus Christ to all who believe. There is no difference. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. That famous verse 23, and are justified freely by his grace through the redemption that came by Christ Jesus. God presented him as a sacrifice of atonement through faith in his blood. He did this to demonstrate his justice because in his forbearance he had left the sins committed. And so he did so to demonstrate his justice at the present time so as to be just, the one who justifies those who have faith in Jesus. Well, today we're going to talk about the balance of that and how it fits into all of our lives. So verse 27 starts off with, where then is boasting? It is excluded. On what principle? On that of observing the law. No, but on that of faith. For we maintain that a man is justified by faith apart from observing the law. Is God the God of Jews only? Is he not the God of Gentiles too? Yes, of Gentiles too. Since there's only one God who will justify the circumcised by faith and the uncircumcised through the same faith, do we then nullify this law by this faith? Not at all. Rather, we uphold the law. What then shall we say about Abraham, our forefather, discovered in this matter? If, in fact, Abraham was justified by works, he had something to boast about, but not before God. What does the scripture say? Well, Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness. So God reveals his righteousness in acting for the salvation of his people. And by providing that redemption through Christ's death rather than by the law, God made it possible for righteousness to be received by faith. God provides a free gift that is to be received by faith by people. So in one of the earliest Christian documents outside the New Testament, Clement wrote in a letter from Rome to Corinth that Christians are not justified through ourselves or through our own wisdom or understanding or piety or works which we have done in holiness of heart, but through faith, by which the Almighty God has justified all who have existed from the beginning. Now, the status of being declared righteous by God is Paul's illustrated this action by God in the experience of Abraham. Starting in Romans 4, righteousness is always the central matter of the relationship of God and men. It was the focal issue in the Old Covenant law because it was essentially what the law demanded. So now in the New Covenant, righteousness is still the crucial issue taken up by the gospel. In Christ, anyone can be declared righteous by faith. This new relationship with God is a genuine transformation in the individual, and the change is in status, heart, and spirit. The righteousness that the believer receives is a pardon from sin, not an increase in personal virtue or moral turpitude or fortitude. This is often confusing for new believers who discover that their justification has not rendered them morally perfect. We are not perfect, even though we are saved. And sometimes that gets confusing after your first walk through salvation. Now, justification is an act of forgiveness by God described in terms of a legal proceeding. God is not pretending that we are something other than what we are, or merely treating us just as if we'd never sinned. He removes the guilt of all our sins, changes our verdict from condemned to acquitted, and changes our relationship with him. That's the most important fact of life. Folks, I got to tell you, if you take nothing away from what we've talked about today, understand that there is a life-changing transformation that God wants for each of us. And it takes only the basic understanding of faith, relationship of trust, and believing in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And if you have questions about how to do that, or if you have questions about whether your heart is full in the riches of Christ, come talk to us. Give us an opportunity to share our words of testimony with you. Give you an opportunity to understand the greatest gift that is ever received by man, and that's Jesus Christ our Lord. Thank you so much. Enjoy the balance of the day. God bless all of you.